हॅलो स्टुडंट्स, मायसेल्फ सिद्धेश्वर बी तुळजापुरे, असोसिएट प्रोफेसर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ मेकॅनिकल इंजिनिअरिंग, वालचंद इन्स्टिट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नॉलॉजी, सोलापूर. सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डील विथ द टॉपिक इंट्रोडक्शन टू टर्निंग मोमेंट डायग्राम. द लर्निंग आउटकम ऑफ दिस सेशन: ॲट द एंड ऑफ दिस सेशन स्टुडंट्स विल बी एबल टू इंटरप्रिट द टर्निंग मोमेंट डायग्राम. The contents are: definition of turning moment diagram, plotting turning moment diagram, areas or fields requiring consideration of turning moment diagram, cause of variation of output torque, terminologies in turning moment diagram, and references. First of all, definition of turning moment diagram. Turning moment diagram, also known as crank effort diagram, is the graphical representation of the turning moment or crank effort for various angular positions of the crank. Now the definition we can observe, it is nothing but it is graphical representation, and that representation is between two parameters. One, it is the turning moment or the crank effort, or it is also called as torque, and the second parameter is the angular position of the crank. So between these two, what relation is there, that will be represented on the graph, and that graph, it will be called as turning moment diagram. Plotting the turning moment diagram. So it is plotted on the Cartesian coordinates, and in the Cartesian coordinates we are having that x-axis and y-axis. On the x-axis or the abscissa we can take the crank angle, and on the ordinate or y-axis we have to take the turning moment. Now this is an example of a turning moment diagram. Now in case of this one, we can observe that we are having the x-axis here, and the x-axis, it is representing the crank angle, that is various angular positions of the crank, and it is represented as theta, so it will be in terms of, say, radians. And we are having on the y-axis the torque or the turning moment or crank effort it is. Now in case of this diagram, you might observe that we are having this blue colored line. So this blue colored curved line, it is indicating the torque or the turning moment at various positions of the crank it is. So now you can take some, say, crank angle, it is say theta 1, and you can go vertically upwards, you will get the corresponding torque here. So you can go for another angle, crank angle, it is theta 2, and you will get the corresponding torque here. Like this, with the help of this graph, what we can observe is there is variation of torque with reference to the crank angle. That is, the torque is not remaining constant. So it is now, in case of this one, there is no the blue colored straight line which is horizontal, which is representing the constant torque with reference to the crank angle. That is, there is variation of the torque with reference to the crank angle. Now in case of this one, you can observe on the lower side, it is written as one cycle. So one cycle refers to the, say, the crank angle rotation. So it is from 0 to, we have taken here, up to, say, it is theta 1, etc. So here, after this part, we are, if we are plotting the, again, the values of the torque against the crank angle, we are going to have the repetition of the same curve it is. That is, the repetition of the torque and crank angle curve, it is going to take place after this one. So here up to this one, we are going to call it as one cycle. This one cycle is representing nothing but it is crank angle rotation only, but it might vary with reference to the different types of the machines which we are using. So it might be, say, 180 degree, it might be 360 degree, or even it might be 720 degree, etc. Areas or fields requiring the consideration of turning moment diagram. Turning moment diagram needs to be considered when there is variation of the output torque in a cycle. That is, the power source cannot provide the constant torque or the turning moment. Now, think of which are the power sources that cannot give the constant output torque throughout a cycle. You can think of the different power sources, like the internal combustion engines are there, like petrol engine, diesel engine, etc. You can think of the external combustion engines having the reciprocating motion, like say reciprocating steam engine. Then you can think of electric motor, etc. So out of this, which is the power source which cannot provide the constant output torque throughout the cycle? So the answer is, these power sources are internal combustion engines like say petrol and diesel engines, and also the external combustion engines like steam engines. So in case of this one, it is reciprocating steam engine, and in both these cases you can see that we are having one power stroke at regular interval. Now see the cause of variation of the output torque. The diagram it is now representing internal combustion engine. In case of this one, on the top side, we can see that we are having the spark plug, or it is fuel injector is there. So in case of internal combustion engine, we are having different strokes, as say it is initially suction stroke, then it is compression, then it is ignition, and then it is lastly the exhaust stroke is there. So in case of the ignition stroke, we are going to have the ignition of the fuel inside this cylinder, and then we are going to have the power stroke. The piston, it will be pushed vertically downward in the present case, and we are going to have the crank rotation. So this power stroke is not continuous. So suction, then compression, then power stroke, and then lastly we are coming to the exhaust stroke. So the power is available only during the power stroke or the ignition stroke it is. So that is the cause of variation of the output torque. We can think of the say reciprocating steam engine. In case of the reciprocating steam engine, now here it is, the cylinder is there. So now the steam is generated outside, and say the expansion of the steam it is taking place, and the piston it will be moved towards the right hand side, and then the rotation of the crank it is going to take place, and based on whether it is double acting or single acting, etc., the backward motion of the piston it will be dependent on this side also. If the expansion of steam is taking place, the piston will be pushed due to the say pressure of the steam towards the left hand side it is. So like this, in this case also we are now having the intermittent power stroke will be there, so not continuous one. And even during the power stroke, the speed it is going to vary because the pressure it is going to vary. Terminologies in turning moment diagram. In case of the turning moment diagram, the present one, it is say turning moment diagram for a 4-stroke cycle internal combustion engine. And as told to you earlier, you can see that here it is suction stroke, compression stroke, working stroke, and the exhaust stroke is there. And this one, it is turning moment diagram is there. So here the first term, it is mean resisting torque. Now suppose the IC engine, it is connected to a vehicle, and that vehicle is carrying a constant load from one place to another place. That vehicle, it has to move, and that load is to be displaced from one place to another place. So the corresponding to that constant load, we are having this one as T mean it is. So it is torque mean resisting torque we are going to call. This much it is constant requirement. Then energy, or it is the work done. So you can see that this we are going to have these different areas which are representing the energies. And now we are having the excess energy or the shortage of energy. Now in case of this one, the T mean line we have observed. Above this one, whatever portion of that turning moment diagram it is lying, it is representing the excess energy. So this triangle is there, which is representing excess energy. And on the lower side, you can observe that sometimes there is energy generation, and if it is falling below zero, so it is called as negative loop, energy will be consumed here. So either we are going to have the shortage, or we are going to have the excess of the energy, and whereas the requirement it is constant. You can see that the turning moment diagram for a single cylinder steam engine, which is double acting. So in case of the double acting steam engine, so 0 to 180 will be one cycle. And after this one, you can see that the curve has been repeated from 180 to 360 degree. then it is turning moment diagram for multi-cylinder IC engine. So in case of the crank is driven by number of cylinders, like in case of the four-wheelers or say the trucks and say buses, etc., number of cylinders we might have. So cylinder number one corresponding to this one, the turning moment diagram is there. Corresponding to cylinder number 2 and 3 also the turning moment diagram is there. So in case of this one, the resultant turning moment diagram is shown on the upper side. And then the mean corresponding to the load, which is going to be constant, the mean torque line, it has been shown here. These are the references which are used for this session. Thank you.